True believers and newcomers alike, this is Sports Store on Enterprise Television. I bid you welcome to the program that serves you a sweet dish of the hot topics in sports. I'm Josh Ikeokoli, and here is what we'll be looking at today. The Super Eagles gone for 3 points to assure AFCON 2025 finals ticket on Thursday against Benin Republic. In the CAF Women's Champions League, Nigeria's representative Edo Queens end in a stalemate with Marsa FC. In tennis, Carlos Alcaraz, Jannik Sinner inch closer to ATP Finals semis in Turin. Let's take a short break on Sports Store. When we return, we will dive deeper into our package for the day. Welcome back to Sports Store on Enterprise Television, and let's start up with the fact that three-time AFCON champions, the Super Eagles of Nigeria, now know that they will qualify for the 35th AFCON Cup of Nations finals tournament if they overcome the Cheetahs of Benin Republic in a 2025 AFCON qualifiers. That game is set later for Abidjan on Thursday, and after 3 wins out of their earlier 4 games, the only draw being the Match Day 2 session with Rwanda in Kigali, the Super Eagles are riding high with 10 points, 4 more than 7th place Benin Republic, who suffered a loss in Kigali in the last round of games. And a win virtually guarantees Nigeria's leadership of the group going into the final match day. And on the other hand, the Cheetahs with 6 points know they cannot afford any more slip-ups following their loss in Kigali, and as they could still fail to qualify if they lose their last 2 games, and Rwanda, who have 5 points, earn a minimum of 2 points in their own final 2 games. And even Libya with only 1 point can still leap over Benin Republic if they beat Rwanda in Kigali and the Cheetahs in the last match day of the AFCON 2025 qualifiers. If the Knights rout the Cheetahs in North Africa on Monday, with England-based centre-back Semi Ajayi absent as a result of injury, coach Austin Eguavoen is most likely to start with the rear guard that squared up against the Mediterranean Knights of Libya in Uyo last month, meaning that captain William Troost-Ekong and Calvin Bassey would start at centre-back, with wing-backs Olaoluwa Aina and Bruno Onyemaechi, Wilfred Ndidi, Alex Iwobi, Fisayo Delebashiru, Alassane Youssouf, and the couple of defensive midfielders like Frank Onyeka and Rafael Onyedika are all available for the spaces in the middle. And with Victor Osimhen back in the lineup, he, Ademola Lookman, Moses Simon, and Victor Boniface alongside Samuel Chukwueze are all in the selection pool for the fall on Thursday. Victory will render Monday's concluding qualifier against Rwanda at the Gosu Lafabio Stadium in Uyo an academic session, with only the visitors keen to try and get something out of the clash while the Eagles play for share pride if the Super Eagles can beat the Cheetahs on Thursday in Abidjan. And joining us virtually to help preview the Super Eagles clash against the Cheetahs of Benin Republic, I have Pius Ahamba. He's a sports presenter, producer, and content creator, Topmost Sports on Lasgidi FM. Welcome to the program, Pius.
Thank you so much, Josh, for this opportunity once again to be on Sports Talk. And of course, as always, I'm always delighted to be here again.
Definitely. Talking about the Super Eagles of Nigeria, Nigeria are playing the Cheetahs of Benin Republic today. The last time we played Benin Republic in a game away from home, Gernot Rohr's team defeated Nigeria 2-1. That was under the tutelage of Coach Finidi George. Austin Eguavoen defeated Gernot Rohr 3-0 in Uyo, match day one of the AFCON 2025 qualifiers. And he has posited that the Eagles are in Abidjan, not for the draw to qualify us, but for the win to secure top spot in Group D. Can the Super Eagles enact vengeance against Benin Republic, or will Benin find a way to get the 3 points against Nigeria?
The truth is, I honestly don't think there should be any reason to worry when we are playing against Benin Republic if we actually a very serious team. I mean, these are the kind of games where you expect players to, you know, stack up numbers, just get goals, score goals. Those who are looking at pushing a record, these are the kind of games they want to enjoy to play and, of course, get goals. But in recent time, we've seen that the Super Eagles are not where they used to be. And that is why some of us are not really, you know, being expectant of a huge scoreline or result. So, be that as it may, I think the Super Eagles should be able to do this one. Both teams are playing away from home, and I think it should be a good avenue to teach Gedetro a big lesson. I think Gedetro is one manager that knows the Super Eagles very well, and he already has he understands how to play the Super Eagles. And I mean, we saw the last time. So I think it's a game we should be able to win. Looking at the stats already in camp, I think we should be able to get the maximum 3 points. Yes, we don't need all 3 points, but yes, we should be able to get all 3 points against the Republic. That's how to show superiority. That's how to command respect on the continent of Africa.
Gabriel Osho, who plays for Auxerre last season, was at Luton Town in the champion in the Premiership before they got relegated to the Championship. He played for Auxerre in Ligue 1 in France. Osho, this is his first call up. And we do not have Shemi Ajayi, who is the regular centre-back partner to William Troost-Ekong and Calvin Bassey, especially when we play a three-man backline. Should Gabriel Osho start against Benin Republic? Because this guy has been impressive for Luton Town and now for Auxerre. Is this the right time, right game to feature Osho for the Super Eagles?
Well, maybe or maybe not, because as an experience, he's one player I've actually longed for in the Super Eagles. I think he's one player. I mean, we also saw him at Luton Town last season. For those who do not want the French League on, a lot of Nigerians, with due respect to Nigerians, watch the Premier League more than watch other leagues. So if you have not even seen him with Auxerre in the league, or you must have seen him one or two times last season playing for Luton Town, especially if you are playing against your favorite team. So this is one player who has actually grown, he has matured over the years. Whether it's a good game to start him, I honestly don't think it would be a very good idea to rush him. Because we have defenders who can actually still partner Troost-Ekong. Of course, Troost-Ekong is going to start that game as the captain of the side. But I think we have a couple of defenders who can actually partner Troost-Ekong. Maybe bringing him up in the second half and not starting him outrightly would be a good idea for me. Because, yes, give or take, he's still going to learn how to, you know, because partnership is one thing. Getting to know your partner is another thing. You can get to start a game, but then do you really understand your partner? I don't think the manager talking about this Oguavon will take that risk of you know, starting him, because like the manager also said, he wants to get all 3 points, and getting all 3 points, you probably don't want to take risks with somebody who really does not understand it. That's not to say if he starts, he's not going to do a good job. Like I mentioned earlier, his experience is also played a couple of games. So he's one player who I would love to see on the bench, maybe in the second 45 minutes when we must have gotten the job done. Then you can just throw him in and lock up shop. Something of that nature.
Okay, so contrasting Eguavoen, this is his fourth stint as the manager of the national team. He's still not confirmed as the full-time manager. He's still in an interim role. Should the Super Eagles beat Benin Republic, beat Rwanda, should Austin Eguavoen be given the full-time role as the manager of the Super Eagles moving forward?
Well, to be honest with you, Josh, I honestly don't see the reason why he should not be given the full-time job role. With or without this game, or the game against Benin Republic, I this is not me saying I have 100% in the manager, because I think a lot of guys on this particular channel would know my view about the Super Eagles and home-based managers. But it's who we have at this point in time. I don't think it would be wise or ideal for us to let him go and start looking for another coach all over again. We saw what the last German, Labadia, did with us and all of that. I don't think the nation, the country is... I don't think we should be messing ourselves around the world, are showcasing our ignorance and, of course, our inability to coordinate ourselves very, very well. Because if we let Eguavoen go right now, trust me, I'm not confident about who they are going to get, how they are going to get the person, and when they are going to get the person. That's my problem. Again, it is not me saying I have 100% in Eguavoen. He's who we have at this point in time. I think we just have to make do with who we have at this point in time. And I don't think he has done a bad job, to be fair, on the man. He has managed a couple of games, and he has actually been doing well. So he would eventually still, you know, coordinate himself and himself grow more. I think with or without this game against Benin Republic, just let this man get the job and let us just get all of this done with. I am not one that would seek for him being removed and then we'll start going round and round. We know how many months it took us to get the last manager, talking about just Peseiro. After Peseiro left, we know how many weeks or how many months it took us to get Finidi George. Finidi George left, we know how many months or weeks it took us. And then we are having Guavuena as interim.
And Finidi George didn't even get a win in the four games he played.
Yeah, he did not, unfortunately. But it's what it is. I'm looking at the time frame right now. We are not coordinated administratively. We don't know what we are doing in this part of the world, to be honest with you, because I don't think it is rocket science. I don't think we are short of coaches in the world at this point in time. Even coaches that will fit our budget, I don't think we are short of those coaches in the world right now. But I don't know, those who administer football in Nigeria, I don't think they understand this thing. So in order for us to stop messing ourselves, of course, making a fool of ourselves around the globe, I think we should just make do with Osinaga Agbapuen, give him the job on a permanent basis, and let's get all of this done with.
Well, definitely, we hope that he can get the 3 points or even the draw against Benin Republic in Abidjan, and perhaps, because that's the most important one, the World Cup qualifiers that will be coming up next year, because Nigeria in a precarious position in that group.
We are in a messy situation in that particular one. I think if he doesn't even get us the World Cup, no one would blame him, or no one would have fought him for that. So we are already in a messy situation. The last two coaches we hired already put us in a very dicey situation. So I think getting us to the AFCON, maybe even doing well in Morocco next year, probably be a good one for him.
So what's your prediction for this game against Benin Republic? Straight win, draw, over 2.5?
It might be, over 1.5 would be a good one. I would go for a Nigeria win, maybe a slim win, 1-0, thereabouts should be okay.
Well, 1-0 should be okay. Thank you, Pius Ahamba, for your time and for incisive analysis on the Super Eagles game against Benin Republic.
Yeah, always a pleasure, Josh.
Definitely. And the last time that Nigeria played Benin Republic, last time Nigeria defeated Benin Republic in a game away from home, the goal was scored by Paul Ebere Onuachu. Gernot Troy, who is the current manager of Benin Republic, was the manager for Nigeria in that particular encounter. Moving over to other stories, let's say that despite being on top of the group, the hope of the Nigeria Women's Football League champions, Edo Queens, in reaching the semi-final of the ongoing CAF Women's Champions League playoffs is presently shaky. The Wafubi champions entered the second game against Masar FC of Egypt, brimming with confidence after a comfortable 3-0 victory in their opening game against CBE FC of Ethiopia. But it was not meant to be, as they could not break down the strong backline of the Egyptian women champions. The game ended goalless, but Edo Queens are still top of their group with 4 points, only better than Masar FC on goal difference. The 4-0 victory of the defending champions Mamelodi Sundown against CBE FC earlier in the day threw the group open, and going into the final game, Edo Queens must avoid defeat against Mamelodi Sundown and also hope that Masar FC struggles against the Ethiopian club to qualify for the knockout stage of the CAF Women's Champions League. In tennis, Carlos Alcaraz overcame illness to beat Andrei Rublev in impressive fashion and revive his ATP Finals hope with a 6-3, 7-6, 10-8 victory in Turin. The four-time Grand Slam champion has been suffering with respiratory issues during the week, which contributed to an opening round robbing defeat to Casper Ruud on Monday. But the third seed, bidding to win the season-ending finals for the first time, looked far sharper against the Russian Rublev, condemning his opponent to a second defeat in as many matches as he triumphed in straight sets. Later on Wednesday, Alexander Zverev took a huge step toward the semi-final place with a straight sets win over Casper Ruud in an entertaining contest. Zverev is all but guaranteed a place in the last four after he beat 6-seed Ruud 7-6, 6-3 in a tight first set that went the way of Zverev, who sent down a 144-meter-per-hour ace to clinch the opener on a very keenly contested tie break week. With momentum on his side, New World number 2 Zverev managed to break in the 8th game to follow up his victory over Rublev and sit top of the John Newcombe group. Rublev has now lost 6 successive matches in straight sets at the ATP final since he reached the semifinals in 2022. Alcaraz is still likely to need to beat world number 2 Zverev in his last group game on Friday in order to qualify for the final 4. Let's go over to the other group games activities at the ATP finals as Taylor Fritz's journey at the tournament came to an abrupt end, falling to world number 1 Jannik Sinner in straight sets. Fritz faced critical moments, serving at 4-5 in both sets, but his performance faltered, and in the first set, he stumbled at 15-30, caught off guard by a drop shot from Sinner, but in the second set with the score at 30-30, a routine backhand from Fritz fell into the net, and both blunders were immediately capitalized on by the Italian home favorite Jannik Sinner, who intensified his forehand shots, forcing errors from the American to secure the set and the match with a score of 6-4, 6-4. Former ATP Finals champion Daniil Medvedev brushed aside debutant Alex de Minaur to bounce back from an opening defeat and boost his hopes of making the knockout phase of the tournament. The Russian Medvedev, who lost his first group stage match to Taylor Fritz, overpowered de Minaur in Turin to win 6-2, 6-4 and leave his opponent on the brink of elimination. Australian de Minaur will be knocked out with a match to spare if the other tie in the Ilie Nastase group between Jannik Sinner goes to 3 sets later on in the day. The 4th seed will next face world number 1 and title favorite Jannik Sinner on Thursday. That's how much we can take on sports talk for the day. Endeavor to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We are Enterprise TV 7 on YouTube. Click the notification bell to get alerts on our new YouTube videos. Follow us on all our social media platforms. We are Enterprise TV 7 on Facebook, Instagram, X, and TikTok. Like, share, and engage with our content. And also visit our website, www.enterprisetvnews.com, where we give you all the hot stories on the go, the live updates, the exclusives, and the news you can use. Moreover, if you want to partner with us on Enterprise Television, you want to place your product on our platform, and for all sponsorship and advertising inquiries, kindly send a mail to enterprisetv7@gmail.com or send a DM to our aforementioned social media handles at EnterpriseTV7. And before we go, let's leave you with this quote from Natasha Hastings, American track and field sprinter. She said, and I quote, "You never know what you're capable of until you take that first step and just go for it," end quote. I'm Joshua Okoli, and I want to thank you for the privilege of your time. Until we meet again, it's goodbye and hasta luego.
Enterprise TV, a tradition of truth.